I am Amira Yahyewi. I'm 27 years old from Tunisia. I am a human rights activist, especially in internet. I am just an activist. I studied maths, which has nothing to do with what I'm doing now and what I want to do in the future. And all my, for 10 years I only do that, trying to change something in the country. Even I didn't change the country, but I'm not the only one. Many people worked hard during these years. People were killed during these years. People were tortured during these years for this. What has changed since Ben Ali left? What has changed is that we have the freedom of expression. It's a real thing. We have it, and I don't think we can go back. It's impossible. But there is a problem, is that we have the freedom of expression, but this freedom of expression doesn't impact politics. Now, it's different than under Ben Ali regime. We can talk, but it doesn't change anything. And this is the problem. So now I think that Tunisians have to show to the governments that if they criticize them, it's for something. Not just to speak. It's not just to blah, blah, blah. It's to change something, and they are asking for things. So I think, I hope with this new government, it will change. I never thought I will vote, really. I never thought it will be possible, because the activists and in Tunisia, we were very pessimist about the Tunisian because of this problem, the soft dictatorship. He succeeded to put in people's mind that Tunisia was an Arab democracy. So it was an Arab democracy where a woman can put dresses and go in bikini to the beach. So this is democracy. And he was very smart on that. So for me, Ben Ali was the creator of this new thing called the soft dictatorship. And many people didn't know till the revolution that Tunisia was a dictatorship. No one wants, because it's a proportional regime. Everybody can say he won, because Nahda, which is the Islamist party, got 40%, and they have the biggest result, 40%. But the modernists can also say that they won, because all the modernists together have 60%. And it's a good thing also, because now they have to work with each other. We don't have one who is strongest, really strongest than the other. Everybody have to do consensus with the others. And I think we couldn't have a better result. People usually see in short time, they see, today, Nahda got 40%, it's a very huge problem, the dictator is back again, and it's a very bad dictator because we don't even have the right to drink beers. That's what they say, but what I say is that we will create the first democratic Arab country. And for me, when I see what's happening in Bahrain and what's happening in Syria and other countries, I feel responsible not only for Tunisia, I feel responsible for the region. And I feel responsible for all the countries who live under dictatorships. I mean, we have to succeed. Tunisia don't have the right to fail. That's the thing. it's not a choice. It's very simple for me because it's not a choice for me. I can't do anything else. That's where I breathe, and that's where I think only about that, and that's why now I have to do that. I am going back to Tunisia in January. I'm still living in France. I'm not really living in France now. After the revolution, I'm living everywhere in the world. Now I'm in Berlin. Yesterday I was in Brussels, and next month I will be in Washington, etc. But I am going back to Tunisia. I think that we can't build the country now from Paris or everywhere. We can only build it in Tunisia. And that's why I'm creating this Parliament Monitor and this NGO. I hope that the young Europeans stop this feeling I really feel that they don't care. Yeah, because the government do whatever they want, and because we can do politics, because politics sucks and politics is a bad thing. No, politics is the thing that can change the world and that can change their country. And with the crisis and with all this problem Europeans now are facing, I hope only to see them, going out and doing something and proposing things. Don't have only to, you have to struggle and to demonstrate against things, and you have, if you want to succeed, you have to propose things, and I hope seeing that.